Why is the AMOC so unstable and could collapse? For 12,000 years, the AMOC system has balanced sea levels and supported Earth's climate. If it collapses, we could see devastating flooding in cities like Miami and New York, while the UK endures brutal Siberian winters. Even the Amazon rainforest, an oxygen lifeline for the planet, could be severely affected. But why has this once stable system become a source of global concern? Clearly, there's an ongoing debate among experts. Some argue that the AMOC is already weakening, while others believe the evidence isn't conclusive yet. But today, we'll break down the science behind the AMOC's predicted collapse and the latest research on its instability. Ocean temperatures are breaking records worldwide. February and March 2024 saw average sea surface temperatures hit a whopping 21.09 degrees Celsius or 69.8 degrees Fahrenheit, topping the previous record of 20.98 degrees Celsius from August 2023. But there's a bizarre exception in the North Atlantic, a cold patch of water nicknamed the cold blob or warming hole. This anomaly, located south of Greenland and west of Ireland, defies climate models and has scientists scratching their heads. It's also affecting the Atlantic Meridional Overturning Circulation, or AMOC, a critical part of Earth's climate system. Some suggest it's linked to the melting Greenland ice sheet, with hundreds of billions of tons of ice pouring into the ocean each year, making the water less salty and contributing to AMOC slowing down. Until recently, experts believed the AMOC would stay intact through the 21st century. But cutting-edge research now hints at a collapse as soon as 2037, just 12 years away. This could have dire consequences for global weather and sea levels. Stick around, because we're diving into the science behind the AMOC, its mysterious connection to the cold blob, and what this means for our planet. First, though, let's lay out some key context. The Atlantic Meridional Overturning Circulation, or AMOC, is one of the planet's most critical systems. Often described as a giant conveyor belt, it moves warm water from the tropics northward and sends cooler water back down south. This process doesn't just circulate water, it helps regulate global climate, making it essential for maintaining stable weather patterns. Here's how it works. Warm, salty water in the Atlantic Ocean travels northward near the surface. As it reaches colder regions like the North Atlantic, the water cools down, becomes denser, and sinks. This sinking action drives the current, which loops back southward into the deep ocean. The AMOC is a key player in balancing temperatures and distributing heat, ensuring that no region becomes too hot or cold. The AMOC's influence is massive. It affects rainfall in the tropics, winter temperatures in Europe, and even the strength of hurricanes in the Atlantic. Without it, many of the weather patterns we take for granted could unravel. The Gulf Stream is just one small piece of the much larger AMOC system. Located near the surface and flowing along Florida's coast, the Gulf Stream is crucial to the mild climate in northwestern Europe. Without it, winters there would be far colder. As the Gulf Stream travels across the Atlantic, it gradually loses heat to the atmosphere. This process, known as evaporation, leaves the water colder and saltier. Eventually, this denser water encounters the fresher waters of the North Atlantic. Being heavier, the salty water sinks, becoming part of the deep-sea current that drives the AMOC. This system is a vital component of the global thermohaline circulation, which regulates Earth's climate. Interestingly, the AMOC hasn't always been stable. Throughout Earth's geological history, it has collapsed multiple times, triggering dramatic changes in climate. Hey guys, just a moment. If you're enjoying this video, give it a thumbs up, subscribe, and make sure to hit that bell icon. Now, let's travel back a bit. If we dive into the past climate, especially from the last ice age and earlier, we come across the Dansgaard-Oeschger events. These events were driven by natural variability in Earth's climate system, during which the AMOC went through shifts between two distinct states. But back then, the climate was far different. Ice sheets covered Europe and North America, adding layers of complexity to the system. Fast forward to today, and climate change has become the primary force driving the AMOC's behavior. A key tipping mechanism is the salt advection feedback, where fresh water accumulates in the North Atlantic, eventually pushing the AMOC towards the tipping point. While this mechanism is similar to past events, there are still differences in how the AMOC is being forced today. One of the challenges facing climate modelers is identifying these subtle differences and accurately factoring them into the complex calculations done by supercomputers. In the past, scientists made predictions about the AMOC shutdown using conceptual models and statistical analyses of proxy data. However, these models likely underestimated how quickly our ocean systems are changing. Recent studies have relied on reanalysis data, which combines observational data with climate models to paint a more accurate picture of the current state of the system. Reanalysis is a method that fills in gaps where observations are missing, helping create a clearer understanding of past and present climates. By analyzing these reconstructions, scientists can make better predictions about future climate trends and potential tipping points for the AMOC. So, how is this done? You might assume that to really understand what's happening in the North Atlantic, you need to take all your measurements up there, right? Well, this idea was challenged back in 1996 by climatologist Stefan Ramsdorf of the Potsdam Institute for Climate Impact Research. Ramsdorf and his team suggested that it might actually make more sense to measure the salinity of the water at the southern boundary of the Atlantic, where it interacts with other ocean currents. Here's where it gets interesting. Ramsdorf proposed that the destabilizing process happening in the North Atlantic, called the salt advection feedback, could actually be measured further south at the 34 South boundary. Think of it this way. The North Atlantic is like a giant basin. It needs to maintain a balance of fresh water and salinity, and not much leaks out from the north. So to really understand how much salinity is entering or leaving the Atlantic, you need to measure it at the southern boundary, because that's where the action is. Measuring at 34 South could be key to understanding potential risks, like an AMOC collapse, making it a crucial spot for tracking oceanic changes that affect the entire system. Now, most of us are just looking for concrete dates on when tipping points might happen. But as you probably realize, things can get complicated. Predicting what's going to happen is no easy feat. So scientists understandably need to present a range of uncertainty in their forecasts, and that principle definitely applies here. For instance, there's a paper that came out in July of 2023, suggesting that a collapse could occur anywhere between 2025 and 2095. Then we have a peer-reviewed study by Renee Van Westen from the Institute for Marine and Atmospheric Research at Utrecht University. This paper, published in February of 2024, points out the inaccuracies of what's known as the Coupled Model Intercomparison Project, or CMIP. It strongly hints at the underestimations of timelines we discussed earlier, although it doesn't offer a specific range of possibilities. Additionally, we've got this recent paper that proposes a 10% chance of an Arctic amplification tipping point happening as soon as 2037, a better than even chance of it occurring before mid-century, and a 90% likelihood by around the 2060s. While these might seem like pretty broad ranges, in geological terms, they're really just a blink of an eye. What's interesting about these latest studies is that they seem to challenge the conclusions from the sixth climate assessment released by the Intergovernmental Panel on Climate Change, the IPCC, in 2033. Experts like Renee Van Westen argue that the IPCC reports, which relied on the results from the CMIP6 models, have significant model biases. The issue arises because the salinity budget appears to be off, leading to a much too stable Atlantic Meridional Overturning Circulation, AMOC. This error occurs from the AMOC being slightly miscalibrated, making it seem way more stable than it actually is. Clearly, we're in a tricky situation where different models don't align, and timelines vary from one study to the next. But the big question remains, if the tipping point is approaching in the not-so-distant future, why are we so focused on pinpointing the exact date of this event? Before diving into that, why should we even care about the predicted AMOC collapse? We don't know exactly when it will happen, but when the AMOC starts to decline, it sets off a chain reaction. Scientists have already observed an acceleration in this decline, which could take about 100 years to transition from its current state to a complete collapse. Over that century, the global climate would undergo dramatic changes. The AMOC is responsible for transporting substantial heat to northwestern Europe, so when this circulation weakens, the region cools significantly. In some areas, temperatures could drop by as much as 10 degrees Celsius. For specific months, like February, some regions might experience temperatures as low as minus 40 degrees Celsius. That's not just shocking, it's downright alarming. But that's only part of the story. The shifting climate doesn't stop with Europe. The tropical rain bands also move, drastically altering weather patterns. One of the most striking changes could occur in the Amazon rainforest, where scientists predict that wet and dry seasons could completely swap. The rainy season might turn dry, and the dry season could become wet. While this might sound fascinating from a purely scientific standpoint, it's terrifying when you consider the societal impacts. Societies can't easily adjust to changes like these. A century might seem like a long time, but in terms of climate and societal adaptation, it's a blink. We're already struggling to manage the current rate of warming, which is around 0.2 degrees Celsius per decade. Northwestern Europe, for example, could face a strange mix of extreme conditions. Winters would become intensely cold, while summers remain much warmer due to global temperature increases. This amplifies the region's seasonality, creating harsher winters alongside significantly hotter summers. On top of that, an AMOC collapse would cause sea levels in the North Atlantic to rise by about 1 meter, a huge concern for coastal regions. Here's an important detail. Although the sea might look flat to us, it actually has subtle slopes stretching across vast distances. These slopes are tied to the strength of ocean currents. If the AMOC collapses or reverses, these slopes would shift, redistributing sea levels globally. That adjustment would contribute to the 1 meter sea level rise in the North Atlantic, leading to widespread coastal flooding. This would displace millions of people, destroy infrastructure, and wreak havoc on ecosystems. The effect of an AMOC collapse wouldn't stop there. As the southern hemisphere warms faster, Antarctica will face accelerated melting. This could destabilize its ice sheets, triggering further sea level rises and amplifying the crisis. Combined with the changes in the Amazon and extreme regional temperature swings, it's clear this isn't just a problem for northwestern Europe. It's a global issue with devastating consequences. Michael Oppenheimer, a professor of geosciences and international affairs at Princeton University, really hit the nail on the head during a recent New York Times event. He pointed out that the situation is serious and we need to step up our efforts to cut emissions. The chances of drastic weather changes over the next few decades are getting higher. Now let's be clear, these discussions aren't meant to scare anyone or come off like a scene from a Hollywood blockbuster like The Day After Tomorrow, which took the idea of the AMOC collapsing and ran with it. That movie exaggerated everything to the point where North America was buried under several feet of ice in just 48 hours. But here's the deal. If there's a real chance that the AMOC's circulation could collapse soon, then knowing the exact moment it will happen isn't the main takeaway. What we should really focus on is that it's going to collapse and what that means for us. It's like driving a truck straight towards a cliff and refusing to hit the brakes until someone can tell you the exact second you'll go over the edge. We need to start taking this seriously. And that's a wrap. What do you think? Is the AMOC collapse a priority for us now? Feel free to leave your answers in the comments below. If you like this video, then you should check out the one on your screen. This video on recent earthquakes and the new Madrid Fault will blow your mind. Thanks for watching.